Welcome back, YouTube Pipe Smokers. The Michigan Piper here, and we're finally back with another video. And today, this review, I am going to be reviewing some Arrowhead. If you guys don't know what Arrowhead is, it is a house blend from Paul's Pipe Shop in Flint, Michigan. And I believe they've been making it, you know, ever since the store's been around, or for a very long while. So, it's a very popular blend from their, that they make, and it's very good, too, you know. It just smokes pretty good. I think it's one of my favorite, aromatics, and I usually don't smoke a whole lot of aromatics, so. This is probably one of my to-go-tos right here, Arrowhead from Paul's Pipe Shop. If you guys really like aromatics, and if you guys like vanilla top notes, I would recommend you go pick up some Arrowhead. It's very good. So I picked it up about over a month ago. And the owner, Dan, he just put about an ounce of Arrowhead in a bag and gave it to me for free. He said, "Here you go, just to try it out. This is our famous house blend that we have." And I tried it out, and I looked before I even smoked it. I looked up the type of tobaccos are in it. Last time I checked, it was Virginia, Latakia, Perique, Virginia. I think I said Virginia's and Burley's. So quite a mixture of stuff, and it has a top note of vanilla. But I don't get vanilla in this blend at all. It's very light though. I know I have to take different draws than I do with over the counter blends, because aromatics do tend to bite a lot more. You know, I usually am not an aromatic guy, but when I tried this blend, I was in love. I love this blend so much. It's very sweet. You don't even smell tobacco. I mean, if you're a pipe smoker, you get that. If you've been smoking, you know, over-the-counter blends like I have for over a year, it has pretty much a distinct smell, but with this aromatic, you don't smell the old codger blend smell. It smells like caramel, but on the Tobacco Reviews website, it's labeled as vanilla as the flavor, but I don't smell vanilla. It's more like a caramel flavor, but with a very light hint of vanilla. And with the Virginias and the Burleys, it just tops it off so well. It makes it more of that chocolatey caramel taste. Pretty good. Just got this new pipe from a local tobacconist, Indian Rivers tobacco traders in Wyoming, Michigan. And if you guys have been to Indian Rivers, if you live in Grand Rapids area, and if you're really into pipe smoking and never heard of Indian Rivers tobacco traders, I would highly recommend you go. They have great amount of selections of pipe tobacco and pipes as well. So this one is a no-named pipe. It's a very long Canadian, and it has some rustication right here. I don't know if it could be from the briar that they carved it up and just said they just kind of winged it, but I still like it. I like the long Canadians. Very neat, very nice. One of the guys that worked there, I can't think of his name, but he took a time out of his day to help fix these up for me, and I bought one other one as well, and they smoke fantastic, folks. So yet again, Indian Rivers have really amazing pipes, although they don't have as much as they used to back in the day, but you can still can get some pretty decent and pretty good pipes. Although, if you want the holy grail of pipes, I would go to Paul's Pipe Shop, where you can find Arrowhead. Arrowhead is amazing, yet again, and they, not only their tobacco is amazing, their pipe selections are over probably the most astounding pipe collection that I've ever seen in my life. It is really unheard of to see a pipe shop in the United States. Yeah, I mean, you got Boswell's and you got other places in Indiana and Ohio, but Paul's Pipe Shop really does take the cake. If you get to talk to Dan, the owner, and another guy that voluntarily works there, carves pipes, does maintenance on pipes, if you get to talk to him, he will more than gladly show you the stuff that they have down in the basement, and also the upstairs, the museum, which I've not yet seen because they're doing some maintenance upstairs. So maybe next time I'll go, maybe this month. I'd like to go once a month because it's like a 2-hour drive from my house to Flint. But it's definitely worth the visit, you guys. And you get to see so much pipes. You're gonna spend at least 5 hours there, maybe even more if you're into pipe smoking. And if you're looking for like a certain blend or a certain pipe that they don't have anymore, more than likely you can buy those new old stock at Paul's Pipe Shop, because I did buy a few new old stock pipes from his store, and I bought it for a pretty good price, about $30 for new old stock, and tell you what, that was worth every penny, and they just smoke fantastic. Like, you just bought them back in the 30s and the 40s and the 50s. Oh man, it's kind of annoying how to relight these aromatics. But yeah, you guys, they got not only Arrowhead, but they got their English blend. I can't remember the name of their English blend, but I tried it out and it was phenomenal. And they also have a cigar leaf blend, which is basically just cigar leaf cut up, and they make it more of an aromatic-y kind of taste, and it tastes like a cigar. And it's more tolerable, too, to a pipe. It might ghost your pipe if you do smoke it, but definitely worth trying out. I think when I do go back to Paul's Pipe Shop, I'm definitely going to pick up some of that cigar blend, that cigar blend. And also, when I was looking in the basement, I happened to find a lot of discontinued blends that they had that had been discontinued for decades. They had Edgeworth Cavendish, Sliced, I think that's what it was. And they had Eight Brothers, kind of like their Siamese twin of the Five Brothers, but I think one has more of a stronger burley than the other, but I could be wrong. if you guys know more about Eight Brothers Burley blend, Burley tobacco, more on the history and when they stopped producing Eight Brothers, feel free to leave it in the comments. But I know this with Five Brothers, they've been around, I think, the longest, the oldest name pipe tobacco brand that's been around since like the 1860s, but the oldest, I think the oldest pipe brands blend still around that you can purchase today. But it's made by the Scandinavian pipe tobacco company. I can't remember the names right now, but you can still purchase it. And I'm gonna have to do a review on that because I do have some Five Brothers, and I got a whole bunch of other stuff to review as well. But yeah, this is Five Brothers, Five Brothers pipe tobacco review. And if you are ever in Flint, Michigan, or in Michigan in general, well, maybe besides if you're up in the UP, I would highly recommend you go visit Paul's Pipe Shop. I know it might be in the video, it might be opposite, the backwards or mirrored, but go pick up some Arrowhead and go pick up a pipe from Paul's Pipe Shop. It's definitely worth the visit. Go talk to Dan, the owner, and go talk to Chris, maybe if he's working there that day. And he will be more than happy to tell you some stories and, you know, some of the pipes that he is building and refurbishing. So that's all I got for you guys. And if you guys enjoy this video, feel free to leave a like, subscribe, and comment. And I hope you guys have a wonderful pipe journey. From our new pipe smokers, and take care and have a good night.